You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, presented by the Only One Media Group. This is the people's choice for quality interviews, celebrities, and special guests. Hosted by Demetrius Dinny Reynolds. Call in to join the mix at 701-801-9813. For the complete archive of episodes, visit onlyonemediagroup.com and be sure to like us on Facebook at Vigilantes Radio. We welcome all. Enjoy the show. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Demetrius Houdini Black Reynolds. Enjoy the show.
At dollarseed.com, all of our seeds are only a dollar a pack. And we have online resources that teach you all about the rewarding hobby of growing your own plants, flowers, herbs, and vegetables. Imagine the joy you'll feel when your children actually help you harvest your first garden crop, or the pride of knowing you'll never need a florist again. Visit dollarseed.com and grow a little magic of your own for just a dollar. Dollarseed.com. What could be healthier?
Hello, hello, hello. What is going on, guys? Welcome to another incredible episode of Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio, and I'm your host, Dini. We have another special guest for you guys, so you definitely want to stick around for that. And as a matter of fact, text your buddies, family members, or even share it on social media right now and let them know that we are about to dive deep into another interview. Before we bring my guest on, I do want to say, well, I actually have a powerful question for you. Here's a question that you can actually ask yourself that will constantly lead you in the direction of success and achievement. And that question is, what can I do to help you? Successful entrepreneurs begin businesses with that question. People rise to positions of leadership by asking this question. Great ideas, inventions, organizations, and works of art spring from this question. Rather than cursing your bad luck when you encounter obstacles, look at what you can do to help. Rather than feeling dismayed when times are hard, find something you can do to help. What can you do to help, you may ask? It will make the difference between allowing life to toss you around and taking control of your destiny. It's a question that can transform problems into opportunities. It's a powerful response to any situation. Those who enjoy real and lasting success are those who continue to find ways to make a difference. Look for what you can do to help, and what you find will be rich and rewarding opportunities. Take that from me, Coach Dini. That is my word, and word is law.
Have you struggled budgeting your finances? Don't worry, you're not alone. Humbledbudget.com. That's HumbledBudget.com is the help and resource you've been searching for. Humbledbudget.com is a personal finance and educational website with a great variety of topics when it comes to budgeting, taxes, investing, and the popular topic of FIRE, financial independence, retire early. Humbledbudget.com has a goal, and that's to help you reach your financial dreams, no matter what your goals are when it comes to finances. It doesn't matter where you start, where you come from, or where you are right now. Humbledbudget.com can help. What are you waiting for? Take that first step to the financial life you've dreamed of and go to humbledbudget.com. That's HumbledBudget. Humbledbudget.com.
All right, again, welcome to the show. You're listening to VRL, that's Vigilantes Radio Live, right here on iHeartRadio, and I'm your host, Dini. Our interviews are designed to go beyond music, news, books, art, acting, films, technology, education, entrepreneurship, entertainment, and sometimes even past that thing that we call the ego. Our interviews are designed to go behind the scenes and into the minds of these incredible human beings, you know, the ones who are out there giving it their all for me, for you, and for the world. Well, ladies and gentlemen, representing the soulful streets of Chicago, today we have NIZZY Get Good, a rapper determined to spread positivity in the world of melancholic melodies. So we will step into the vibrant world of rapper NIZZY Get Good, a lyrical genius inspired by the iconic Nas and shaped by the rhythmic streets of Chicago. We'll discover how he's breathing a fresh life into the rap scene with his positive, high-energy tracks like Wipe It Down and his undying mission to bring back upbeat rap. It's time to manifest good vibes and even better music with NIZZY. With that, let's welcome him to the show. Yo, 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 what is up, man? Welcome.
Hey, how's it going? Thank you for having me.
Pretty good, man. How are you feeling?
I'm doing very well. The kids around, running around, you know. Happy at the time, but everything goes is great.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We're happy to hear that kids running around. It's always a good sign that there's life going on, right? Life
is happy. Yes, sir.
All right, man, before we get into the why and the how you do things, especially when it comes to music, we want to know about the who that's doing this awesome music. So give it to us straight. How did you discover your passion for creating music?
To be 100, like I say, my father, he had me rapping since I was basically out of diapers. Like, he loved Nas, that was his favorite rapper. He wanted to pretend to me, acting like I was a little Bow Wow coming up. But as I learned that I have more of an ear for music. I like art, because I do tattoos, I draw, I do a lot of art. Everything is art. But I learned that my passion for music is different than my love for art and drawing, because I could get tired of drawing and stuff. I could never get tired of doing music, so I know that's what my passion is at, because anytime I hear something in music, I can catch the beat right away. I can do all that. And I learned that my kids are just like me. Like, the song could come on, they never heard a song a day in their life, and now they catching the beat, dancing to it, doing everything.
Wow. That's what's up, man. So was Pops a rapper, or did he just like Nas and kind of foretold your future?
Yeah, he's kind of a rapper. He's not that much like trying to do it professional or anything. Like, he does, you know, like every other father, there's some of them coming up just like things, so they want to try to live it through their kids.
for sure. Man, have you guys collabed yet?
No, we haven't.
Oh, man. Are you ever going to collab with Pops?
No, it's just we be so mixed up. Like, he be saying on, like, sometimes I'm like, coming up, he wasn't around as much as he supposed to be, you know? So
yeah.
I just started making more of a life with him myself. He was just trying, like, instead of being bitter with him and things like that. So that's really why we haven't been around each other as much. And our birthday is actually 2 days apart, you know?
Wow.
So, yeah. We act a lot alike, but my mother say we act nothing alike, too. You know?
So, given that experience growing up, do you put that into your music, especially your relationship with your father?
So many words, yeah. Like, I can say I do that. Like, that's where the positivity thing comes from. Like I say, not letting nothing that you've been through in life stop you from getting to where you want to be. You know, like, actually use that skill, because, like I say, without him being in, with him not being in my life as much, that actually made me to the magnificent person that I am today. So I wouldn't want it any other way, I guess. So.
Yes, sir. So, man, having grown with the mission to bring back happiness and rap, was there ever a moment in your journey where you felt like drifting away from this path?
Let's say, like, because I, like, say, growing up, when I was, like, 13, 14, like, I always had a lot of opportunities, it was this one person, he was, like, Lil Wayne, DJ, he was trying to put me, sign me or some way, but, I'm asking my mother, and, you know, it's at this time, you know, they think, you know, growing up, they think everything is a scam. She, oh, he's trying to scam you, but it actually was Lil Wayne's real DJ, trying to, you know, put me on or whatever. But at the same time, then no one had the money that we needed to put behind me to, you know, invest in my dreams I want coming up. So then I get older, and then in Chicago, people always riding the wave of the person who's the hottest. So it don't matter about if you got all the talent. It's whoever got the name at that moment. So even though I got a lot of talent, they still going with the people who got the name. So yeah, stuff like that make you a little discouraged. And then plus I didn't have the money that I behind myself that I needed. So can't nobody even play me out of some money or out of deal. So, but I always kept to it and kept with the positivity. And I knew like all I got to do is just start making my own money and learning how to get my own money, then I could always put my own cell phone instead of needing someone else to do it.
Yes, sir, man. I like that drive, man. You know, instead of just waiting around for an opportunity, you see something you want, he's like, okay, I'm lacking this part, but I can work towards it. And that's what I like to see in artists, man. Not just someone like, yeah, I can't wait to Usher discover me online after I'll be singing on YouTube. It doesn't happen like that.
Exactly.
But yeah, man, I appreciate that grind. Yo, so you took your name, I won't say you took your name, but you honored Nas by calling yourself Nizzy. That's a real big name to live up to. So tell me, did it ever feel like pressure or more of a force pushing you when it came to your name?
Yeah, it's like me growing up, people always told me I was the chosen one, I'm going to be something. They always had high expectations for me. Like, everybody always told me I was going to be a great man, I'm going to be a great person. Like, I always had this going on in my life. So, and then the fact that me and Nas share the same name, so my nickname growing up, everybody always called me Nas. So it already had the pressure behind it because he's already a great person. So they use it. Since I'm already a person that I'm very smooth, I'm very cool, I'm very outspoken, I'm very someone down to earth, all that things that they think Nas already have, they already comparing me to that, so I'm already expected to be great, so now when I get older and I'm finding out like that Nas was this certain type of person, now me growing up, I didn't even know that his birthday is the day after mine, you know, so it's like, it's like all right, my pop's birthday is 2 days after mine. Nas' birthday is the day after mine. Mine's September 13th. His day birthday September 14th. So I didn't even know that. So of course we kind of act the same. We all Virgos, you know. So that was already there. So as long as I lived up to my expectations, whatever Nas got going on in life or how he was, it didn't even matter because I'm still, like I say, I'm not Nas, I'm Nizzy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like you're saying, like, even though we got the same name, you know, this and that, I'm still creating my own legacy. But I'm still keeping his name alive because at the end of the day, I want people to hear a name Nas or Nasir, and they think of these great individuals behind that name.
Yes, sir. I love it. Man, Chicago has given the world some great music. How has the city shaped your sound?
Because I'm from the east side of Chicago, so it's like the southeast. So I grew up listening to like Bum J. That's one of, he's like one of like the a super hot rapper like from my side of town. And like, got like a first major deal, like, you know, so when it comes down to that, it keeps it like I be learning I still got the east side slang in my voice, like the look, like we have like the monotone tone, like everybody on the east side, they got this monotone voice. I didn't notice that until I got older, but it actually shaped a lot of things in my life because everything that we go through in life, We see things like Chicago, you grow up real fast. Like you see things that a normal individual wouldn't see at a certain age. And you have to grow up real fast. You have to be knowing all your surroundings. You have to be on point at all times. So that helps in what I'm able to put all that in one and be able to put it in my music.
Absolutely. Man, it's time to get into the single, Wipe It Down by NIZZY Get Good, and then we'll be back to put him in our traditional hot seat. That's where you can rap for us, freestyle, or poetry, spoken word, tell a joke, tell a story from your life, play an instrument, or give some advice. The choice is yours. But for right now, here it is, guys. Wipe It Down. Stay tuned.
Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe them down, wipe them down, wipe it down. Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. Clear the milli, man, you know I wiped it down. I'm in the billy, man, I gotta wipe it down. We get the semi, man, we had to wipe it down. You know it's in me, man, I gotta wipe it down. Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. You know it's fast, paper tag 200. Try to run, then we hawking up. I got a mother bit mad. I got a million, I got it all cash. You hating and they faking and debating. Late payment, we deleting and erasing. We take them down, wrap them up in the basement. Paper chasing, I ain't running, I'm just pacing. Money in the attic, turn your to an addict. Only rocking all designer, cause I like to feel the fabric. Don't take it, you can have it on point like a cactus. Put the money in the safe, put the choppers in the mattress. With Chase on the beat, then you bout to feel defeat. Chinchilla on the rug, it feels soft on my feet. This a Frenchie, not a pug. Move wrong, get a slug. And your she a bug, always acting for a hug.
Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe them down, wipe them down, wipe it down. Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. Clear the milli, man, you know I wiped it down. I'm in the billy, man, I gotta wipe it down. We get the semi, man, we had to wipe it down. You know it's in me, man, I gotta wipe it down. Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down. I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
I wipe them down, wipe them down, wipe it down.
Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
Clear the milli, man, you know I wiped it down.
I'm in the billy, man, I gotta wipe it down.
We get the semi, man, we had to wipe it down.
You know it's in me, man, I gotta wipe it down.
Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
Wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
I wipe it down, wipe it down, wipe it down.
All right, guys, welcome back. Welcome back. That was Wipe It Down by NIZZY Get Good. Let's go ahead and bring them back. Yo, 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 you're back live with us and in our hot seat. What are you going to perform for us?
Like I see you said, we either could perform a song, we could just give like what, like, you know, a speech, inspirational. I like I said, I'd rather just give like something, you know, motivational to tell everybody, you know, as far as past the music. That's all regular. But I like to give people more of, like you say, the positivity thing about life and everything, you know.
Yes,
that's how I am.
Yeah, we'll take that, man. So, ready when you are.
Okay, so yeah, so with that being said, like, so everybody, like, when I'm seeing everyone is, you know, bringing us in, I'm trying to bring the positivity to rap. What I mean by that is, like, the reason why the women are winning so much in the music game right now is because it's about happiness. They want us to be happy, you know. People don't like being sad. Like, people like to hear what you went through, but they want to hear where you're going. They want to hear where you're at. You know, like, so when it comes down to me being a positive person, that's something that I work on 24/7, like, all day. I work on building my subconscious mind. I meditate, you know, like I write my to-do list. I do everything I can to keep me always positive by rewriting my subconscious. And that's what I've been doing. So when I'm being positive, I say bringing positivity back to rap, I'm saying that, man. And just talk about more things about only one out of life, where we going, like people want to hear that. So if you learn how to, what the law of attraction is, it's not what everybody pertains to think they know. It's about, it's really the law of vibration. You don't attract what you want, you attract what you are. So if you keep attracting negativity, you necessarily are negativity. That's why I keep coming to you. But you could always rewrite it and make it where you attract everything you want in life. Like, so I'm at the point now where I don't chase my dreams anymore, because when you're chasing something, that comes with the thrill of might not catching it. So I know that I am gonna achieve whatever dream that I want now, because I have been doing that for the last 2 years. I have been doing, practicing all the methods I learned, got all the self-help books, and I've been using it. It's all been working, to the point where I can teach people how to do it themselves. But long story short, and by me learning that I'm not chasing anything no more, that I'm gonna get it for sure, now I get the chance to see, do I want this dream anymore? Like, I can already picture and visualize me having it, and then I can see, does this dream bring me fulfillment now? If it doesn't, I don't try to chase it anymore. I don't even go back to getting. I go to things that bring me fulfillment, which is, what brings me fulfillment is bringing back and giving back to others and helping everyone out and seeing the smile on people's face and making everyone feel great and positive, especially coming from where we're from in Chicago, where there's a lot of negativity going on within the positivity that's out there. So, like, I want to give to others to tell them how to really get what you want out of life. You have to learn how to visualize it. When we say visualize it, you don't mean the picture you have it. No, I mean closing your eyes. Like when a seed is growing in the ground, it is growing, everything is being done in the darkness. And then you, when you look at the seed, you don't look at the plant. You don't plant the seed and then pour the water, and then every day you digging it up out of the ground to see if it started sprouting. No, you did your job. You planted the seed. You pulled the water. You know you got some sunlight. So then you expect the universe to do its job. And as the universe is doing its job, you just come back with the end in mind, picturing the plant already grown. You don't picture all the other stuff that is going to go through, all the weeds that got to grow past. You just picture the end in mind. When you picture the end in mind, just like anything in life, it outpictures. So that's how it is with everything you want in life. You visualize it as if it's already yours. Visualize the end. Don't visualize how you're going to get there. That's the universe job. Let it do its part. But you visualize it every day as if you already got it, as it's done, as the mission is complete. You visualize it so much with emotion that the emotion is so much, it's so real, like you smell the room, you smell the desire or feel the desire as if it's there in your hands, that the visualization was so real that you don't even need it no more in the physical world, because you had it in the spiritual world already. And that's how you get whatever you want. And if you do that for five minutes out the day, every day in your life, I promise you'll be able to get whatever you want out of life.
Absolutely.
That's what I have to say for the people.
Absolutely, man. We appreciate that so much. Just to piggyback on what you said, I do have a follow-up question, man. You're aiming to bring happy rap back. Why do you think the industry shifted towards maybe a sadder, heavier side of things?
Because, like, it with the sadder, heavier side, it promotes. It's more things to promote off that. Like, people being happy, you know, that's like, that's nothing. It's hard to talk about. It's more to talk about things, bad things, than it is happy things for some people, believe it or not. You know, like, I can talk about me. I talk about everything I want out of life. All day I talk about where I'm going. I talk about positivity 24/7, but I do be around people. I know that they love to complain about more things than the happy things, because it's just easier to promote. It's easy for people to want to be mad at life than want to be happy for some reason. I don't know why, but people are, and it's easier for them to do it because it's like this. Every day is a fight between the lower self and the higher self. So, like, I don't believe in the devil or nothing like that. You know, I only believe in God. I believe everything is God. So, at the end of the day, but everything is a fight between the lower self and the higher self. So, people, when they gotta become their higher self, they have to stick to their higher self, which means every day they have to keep becoming their higher self. But it's easy for them to become their lower self, like the Jesus said in the Bible, the lower self, the higher self. What it said, the lower self will never know the higher self, but the higher self will always know the lower self. So the higher self will always know where it could go back to, but the lower self don't never know how far it could really become, you know. So it's easy for people just to give up on themselves. So people rap about it, promote it, and I guess because it's easier to promote.
Yes, sir. Where can our listeners connect with you online?
You can connect with me on, say, on I don't have, I'm about to make a Twitter, I don't have one, but you could definitely connect with me on Instagram, at Nizzy Get Good, NIZZY GETGOOD, and my music, just find me on YouTube, on all platforms, and Nizzy Get Good, and then that's where everything is going to be, on Nizzy Get Good, NIZZY GETGOOD.
All right. Listeners, just in case you did not get those links, no worries. I will have them in the description of this episode. So all you guys have to do is just click the links. Well, Nizzy, man, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for spending it with us. We really appreciate you.
All right. Thank you. No problem. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely, man. Have a great evening.
All right.
Peace.
Are you ready? Listen up. I'm about to help you become a legend. Do you live in Pennsylvania and want to become a professional wrestler? Are you willing to put in the work, but only find schools that want to rip you off? If you want to be a star, you need trainers who have experience and genuinely care about your success. And that's why the Stronghold Wrestling Academy is the only school for you. The Stronghold Wrestling Academy features a full gym and trainers with almost 100 years experience between them. Learn every aspect of the wrestling business, from the art of promos to crafting your persona. And most importantly, learn to wrestle like a pro. The Stronghold Wrestling Academy has graduates who've signed with Impact Wrestling, AEW, and even the WWE. Could you be next? For more information on our open house and upcoming classes, go to risewrestling.com and select train. That's risewrestling.com and select train. Remember, half the battle is believing you have what it takes. The other half is why you have us, the Stronghold Wrestling Academy.
Thank you, my Vigilantes family, as always, for checking out my podcast over here at Vigilantes Radio Live. All episodes are available for free download, and you can grab it from either Spreaker.com/Only One Media Group, Spotify, CastBox, iHeartRadio, iTunes, YouTube, the app Podcast Addict, or over at our website, which again is onlyonemediagroup.com. And that goes for every single show that we've ever aired. If you like to request music or send something for me to play, email it to vradio@onlyonemediagroup.com. That is V as in Victor. And here's my disclaimer. We are genre free. We do not judge, and we absolutely do not base our opinions on hearsay, but facts alone. And actually, scratch all of that, because all of my opinions are always right. That's the bottom line. This is my show, so deal with it. Just kidding. On behalf of myself, Denny, I appreciate all you guys for tuning in, either afterwards or live with us. Spread the word, because sharing is caring. We stepped up our game just for you guys and our guests to make sure that you have the best experience here on our show. Be sure to connect with me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, Snapchat, TikTok, at all social media sites, as well as Spreaker, YouTube. We always follow back. Okay, well, just remember to put yourself into everything that you do and never stop investing in yourself. Peace, love, grilled cheese, and talk with you later.
are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, the people's choice for quality interviews, art, music, and hot topics. Hosted by Demetrius Houdini Black Reynolds of the duo No Longer the Hero. All episodes of this podcast are available for free download at www.onlyonemediagroup.com. This is a Seventh Sign Regime, Rebirth Worldwide Syndicate exclusive.